Look at all these VR180 cameras we have. Wow. The Red V Raptor, aka 120 frame per second VR180 cinema quality camera, the Canon R5 with the Canon RF dual field shot lens, and another Canon R5 with more dual field shot lens. As we continue to innovate in VR storytelling, negative comments are also coming in. Most of them surrounding the topics of 3D VR180 is not truly VR. I don't completely disagree with that. 6 degrees of freedom is part of the evolution of VR XR video in the metaverse. On the other hand, we need to stay true as a filmmaker to capture reality as real as it comes without computer-generated game engine graphics. On the other hand, we need to provide viewers the freedom to move around in the metaverse we capture. This is a very difficult and expensive task to tackle. Today, I'm happy to tell you we have some significant progress to share. Stop calling VR what it is not true VR. We now have the ability to transform any VR180 video into 6DoF experience using WebXR on Meta Quest 2 and other comparable VR headsets. In this video, we will explain why 6DoF is better from a viewer's perspective. We will introduce a new AI technology to transform 3DoF video into 6DoF using depth mapping. I will show you a hands-on workflow using Canon R5 and the Canon RF dual field shot lens to capture, process, and to release your own WebXR 6DoF experience. And I will show you how to share and enjoy it in your Meta Quest 2. We got a lot to cover, let's jump into the metaverse now. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from the Metaverse. A technology I'm going to show you now, which is developed by Livecast VR, is still in very early development beta stage. Yes, there will be lots of artifacts, but also it is very cool. Let me just show you and stop talking. You can see the same result as well on your Oculus Quest 2 VR headset. Go to your Oculus browser, type in one of these three URLs, make sure you use HTTPS instead of HTTP for security reason. You should see this page. Just hit the play icon, the video will play as 180 video on YouTube. But when you hit this Enter VR button, wow! There are lots of artifacts, but at the same time, this is a true 3D 6DoF experience. I can move my head side to side and the image responds. The artifacts are more obvious when I move in a large distance, but in general, I feel less motion sick compared to the traditional 3DoF VR180 experience. Here is a still 3D 180 photo captured with the Canon R5 and dual field shot lens. Here, it is turned into a 6DoF experience. It's kind of like an NFT, a very comfortable blend 3D 180 art, where I can even walk around to see Kitty break down into pieces.
Hey, that is not nice. I am hungry. Feed me.
So, this will support both the photo and the video capture with the Canon EOS VR system. But any VR180 camera will work. You don't necessarily need to use Canon. As you see right here, the example is captured with the Red V Raptor in slow motion. If you don't understand why 6DoF, 6 degree of freedom, is better than 3DoF in the metaverse, let me explain. Six degrees of freedom, aka 6DoF, is the motion system most game engine-based VR experience built up on. Most of the VR180 or 3D stereoscopic 360 video are 3DoF, 3 degrees of freedom. In 3DoF, a user can rotate their head and their view responds. But if they move side to side, their view does not respond. This can potentially cause motion sickness because the user inner ear perception motion while their eyes don't see the same motion. This motion sickness is on a very subconscious level, but it's one of the causes of motion sickness in VR. With Sixthof experience, what you see within the VR headset responds correctly to all motion. Forward, backward, up and down, left and right, yaw, pitch and roll. There is no more disconnect between what you see and what your subconscious tells you. This makes Sixthof experience in general more immersive and comfortable. Furthermore, Sixthof format produces incorrect stereoscopic views in VR headset if the user is using moving their head or look up or down around the horizon area, which can cause eye strains. Sixthof fixed these issues as well. Creating Sixthof video is harder than Sixthof because it requires technology like depth map, photogrammetry, volumetric capture, or live view reconstruction of each frame of the video. There is a lot of research on this topic in academia and big tech companies like Meta, Facebook, Reality Lab, Google, HTC, you name it. But very few practical solutions are available to VR filmmakers and regular viewers like me and you. Microsoft Meta Stage by Christina Heller, Red Manifold, and my friend Tobias Chan's vocap camera system are some of the very expensive early adapters. What we introduce here is an AI software conversion by a little startup called Livecast. Besides paying a very small software licensing fee, the rest can be free if you already own a VR180 camera like the Canon brand new EOS system right here, with you on this channel right here. To go one step further, Livecast AI solution is also working on fixing motion sickness in VR video where the camera moves while recording. Moving VR-worthy camera even on a gimbal can be problematic. Sixthof unlocks the possibility to capture 3D POV VR video with wearable camera, and watching them in a VR just feel like reviewing a memory. Here is a prototype demo of this idea by Livecast VR. By using the power of WebXR, a decentralized Web 3.0 technology, we can view the Sixthof in any VR platform that supports WebXR, like Oculus browser right here. Free with your MetaQuest 2. Even better, for device like mobile phone or web browser that don't support VR, we can view a full-back interactive 180 video just like on YouTube. So you can build your website for the future, but with a nice backward compatibility. In the rest of this video, I will show you how to do exactly that for free. So go ahead, bring your VR1D camera out and go shoot something. You don't need to diffuse with the Canon VR utility. Livecast VR software works directly with Canon RAW fisheye footage. It saves you one extra rendering step. Here, we use the VR1D format instead of the RAW fisheye since my video is already well edited and ready to go. Download the Livecast VR software from the link in the description. It has both Mac and PC version. PC version support NVIDIA GPU for AI learning, so the render speed is a lot faster. Here is the software interface. You can do both image and video. We choose our videos here as input data, output into a JPEG sequence onto a folder. As you see, it will generate four views here, depth map and background layer. The rest, I will leave it untouched. After render is done, you can use FFmpeg to mux all the JPEG into H.264 for web browser and iOS devices, and render an H.265 version for high-quality Oculus browser, WebXR playback, and 1080p video fallback video for very old devices. I will provide all three command lines for PC and Mac in this video description. Just copy and paste, you'll be all good. If you need some help on FFmpeg, check out my Oculus Quest render tutorial right here. I always provide extra value and money to my viewer. This part of the tutorial, I will teach you how to host your web XR experience for free in a secure manner, so everyone in the world can view your experience on any devices. Usually, this might cost you $100 hosting fee per month, but you can get it free with some simple command lines. What we're gonna use is search.sh, a static website deploy solution with HTTPS support. All you need to do is run the below command line in your terminal if you're on a Mac, or CMD if you're on a PC. First, type in npm install global search. You might need to use sudo depending on your Mac setup. Then go to download page and download the website example from this URL. Use a text editor like Sublime, also free by the way, edit the index.html. Change this part into this part with your video name instead. See the video description for detailed write-up. Save your index.html in Sublime, now close Sublime. Now open up the terminal or CMD, go into your website folder, mine is under G Drive. Simply type in S-U-R-G-E, confirm the folder, change your URL to whatever you like, maybe call it Funky Chicken 222, and then hit enter. Now your whole website is uploaded to the Funky Chicken 222.surg.sh. Now put on your Oculus VR headset, open browser, and type in https://funky-chicken-222.srge.sh or whatever URL you choose, and voila! Your first six-stop video now is out on the internet for the world to enjoy in the metaverse and Web 3.0. Thank you so much for watching this kind of in-depth, little bit nerdy, but totally cool video. Help us to help you to stay on the bleeding edge of XR development by liking and sharing this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Instagram page, and Facebook page right here if you have not already. More metaverse friends and creators joining our community help us to give a bigger voice to move the industry in a positive direction, pushing real change in XR development for not only technologists but everyday storytellers like me and you. As always, we love your feedback and comment. 3DoF versus 6DoF is a big discussion in XR development. We just covered the tip of the iceberg. We need your input, the community input, to drive our content strategy so we can better serve you and your interests. We are hungry for XR knowledge. I hope that is you too. Until next time, see you in the metaverse. Ciao.